Hi everyone. In the last video I showed you a bit about this wood star puzzle, which is also called Escher Solid. I showed how it's made out of six identical parts, how you reassemble them. It's some kind of a mind puzzle. And in this video I'll show you how I made those and how I designed the jig to produce them. But before that, I want to show you how they tessellate. A three-dimensional space, no gap. Okay, five of those. And another five. And another five. One more thing about the stacking properties of this object. If you'll put the star instead of this way, if you put it this way on the 3 points here, like this, you can stack on it with no gap in an endless way. You can have a look here. They're all attached with no gaps.
So the first stage would be making a stalk of perfectly square blanks. Making square blanks is quite easy if you have a planer, planing one side and then planing the perpendicular side. Here I'm planing some oak and walnut. I'm using here the fine adjustment mechanism of my table saw to get a precise cut. Here I'm slicing the walnut to stripes. Now I'm cutting it to small blanks in the desired length. Owning a sliding table saw really makes this work quick and easy. I number the pieces so I can check for misalignment later on. I'm changing the blade angle to 45 degrees, just to mention that I never had to fix the angle after using the stops of the saw. Now I'm cutting a 45 degrees curve in the wood in order to hold the blank in the right position while cutting it. The wood piece that I made was too small, so now I'm making a bigger blank for the same purpose. This cut is quite tricky actually, because the piece can easily get loose and kick back at you. You need to be sure to hold it firmly. Now I'm gluing an additional piece to this blank so I can attach it firmly to the fence. Here I'm making a small stop so I can position the blank in the right space. Now I'm making the first 45 angle cut. In order to clamp the jig to my sliding table saw, I'm adding a threaded rod and a knob so I can clamp it to the fence. Now the jig can be connected firmly. With this small simple jig I can easily cut four corners of the blank so I can get the final shape that is needed. But cutting the inner cuts, this was much more problematic and complicated. So I had to spend a lot of time thinking of how should I approach this? How should I cut it? How can I make it simple and accurate at the same time? So here I'm doing all kind of experiments, trying to add another stopper, trying to think how to position it, how to make it more accurate, how to adjust it. So at this point it was quite obvious that the stoppers needs to be adjustable, otherwise it won't be accurate enough. So I was trying to think of kind of mechanism that will allow me to adjust it to a precise position. But first I took care of holding the piece firmly without involving my hands. So I'm using this clamp here, works well. At this point I realized that I need to add slots to make everything on this jig adjustable, so I can adjust it to any desirable size. So I'm making the jig one more time for the third time, all over again. All the process from the beginning. Here I'm chamfering the edges. Here I'm using the hybrid Pantorouter to make the slots from the bottom. I'm leaving space for the screw's heads so they can move easily inside. I had to chip a bit of the screw head so it will fit in. Now, this way all the three different spacers could be easily adjustable, or at least I thought they would be adjustable. I'm adding here a plywood back so I can connect the jig firmly to the fence. This is here a short reminder to be careful even with the simplest tasks. Even when drilling, it could be a bit dangerous if you're not careful enough. Before gluing the piece, I'm making a dry fit. I'm checking that it works and it's aligned. I unscrew it. I add glue and I screw it again. After the glue is set, I remove the screws so they won't interfere with the blade of the saw. .9 degrees angle without any adjustment, that's good enough for me. Now the jig is ready, I'm giving it a test run to see how it works. First step would be to shape the outer sides. Now I'm moving on to the middle cuts, which are more complicated. I'm checking the alignment and I tight the knob to connect it firmly. Now 6 pieces are ready. And I'm trying to connect it, and it's too tight. It doesn't fit. Unfortunately, here I understand quite clearly that mechanism is not working. You can't make fine adjustment as you should. It's too rough and bulky and it's actually not working. But I'm giving it another try. Six pieces are ready now. I'm trying to connect them. And it fits. A bit too loose, but it fits. I have a lot of work to do still on the jig to improve it. Stay tuned for the